wrong side of the wake and just, you know, pushed, and then I almost got it, but the rear came out right before the exit of the corner, and then I just hit the wall, and I tried to stay up there, but eventually I think something broke in the rear, and I just came back on the track, and unfortunately the car hit me, so really unfortunate for him as well. Yeah, we had a hell of a race, man. Really proud of my team. Our McLaren SP entity day, that car was just amazing, and yeah, it's tight. I didn't really have a push like that until that point. Small margins, and I came on the wrong side of it. So, sorry for my team. I had a hell of a run, but glad everyone is okay, and we just have to regroup.
Thank you, Felix.
For a guy who was at the front a lot today, Felix Rosenquist, 33 laps. His McLaren team has led 92 laps in total. What a day for them, but that's not the way that Fro, as he's affectionately known, would like this to have finished. But flying, and it hit the front of the white car where all the yellow shirts are standing around. Nobody injured. No reported injuries. That is a massive relief. Massive relief. Let's join Marty Steiner.
Let's check in with Brian Barnhart as driver Alexander Rossi trying to get his second Indianapolis 500. They'll lift the red here in a moment. Brian, if you were betting on any driver in the field to have a fantastic restart, kind of where would you rank your driver?
Well, right up here near the top. Really happy and proud of the Arrow McLaren guys. Got a couple of great shots up there with Pato and Felix, and or with Alex. And look.
So, the driver of the number 23 Root Chevrolet there for driver Ryan Gold is the 500 winning driver, IndyCar champion Brian Hunter-Reay. I spoke to him about this very scenario and how big coach it. Nashville, Detroit, or Detroit then Nashville.
St. Pete this year.
St. Pete and Indy 500 last year.
Indianapolis, that's not a bad day as those cars on fumes are forced to their pit boxes to top up.
And that opens up the pathway for Pato O'Ward, Marcus Ericsson, Joseph Newgarden, Alexander Rossi, Santino Ferrucci, Alex Palou. Do not count out Alex Palou. I told you that story of a couple of years ago when he had a turn one crash with his teammate. I think it was Felix Rosenquist.
Power to beat the Ganassi's
last mark that you see on that helmet is hand painted. It has a beautiful, I was able to hold it and rub my hand across it. You feel the raised bumps of the paint. It is beautiful matte finish.
And he's so proud. Pato O'Ward, who has a helmet seemingly.
I love the influence that he has had on kids. I see so many kids walking around with the bright papaya. It's the 60th birthday of McLaren
on the restart.
Now I said, could he give McLaren a birthday present? Last JR Johnny Rutherford, 1976. Johnny is here.
Released from the medical center. One, was that one of the most terrifying things you've been a part of? Not only to have have the car spinning in front of you, not be able to see, but then the aftermath as well.
Yeah, I mean, the aftermath, I mean, everything happens so quick, you don't really know what happens. All I've heard right now is that I was up in the fence, which is never a good thing in IndyCar. But thank God these cars are so